Hi, welcome to the session. This episode, we're going to look at Chainsmokers Closer and how to recreate that in Logic Pro X. Closer is a really good track because the Chainsmokers know how to put fairly simple sounds together to create something really special. So let's have a look. So this is our project for Closer. As you can see, the top track here is the vocal track for the song. Only the vocals. And the rest of the bottom tracks here are MIDI, except for one audio track here. This is MIDI as well, and it's at 95 BPM. So let's have a listen to the project.
Doing just fine before I met you. I drank too much and that's an issue, but I'm okay. Hey, you tell your friends it was nice to meet them, but I hope I never see them again. I know it breaks your heart. Moved to the city and I broke down crying. 4 years, no calls. Now you're looking pretty in a hotel bar. And I can't stop. No, I can't stop. So baby, pull me closer in the backseat of your Rover that I know you can't afford. Bite that tattoo on your shoulder. Pull the sheets right off the corner of the mattress that you stole from your roommate back in Boulder. We ain't ever getting older.
So right up to the first chorus, and then the second verse is just a repetition of that. So let's get into it. Okay, for the opening, right, there is a piano, and basically what we use was under the acoustic pianos, Steinway grand piano, and this is the MIDI that's playing. So you can access that from the project download itself. Now what we put in was a filter, and what I picked was a constant rise 4 bars, right? So what you're getting is a constant rise across 4 bars, and I tweaked the rate, and this is 4 bars. I'm not sure if I tweaked it, and also I added a reverb on the track itself, and what I picked was a large space room 2.7 seconds big chamber. Change the dry and reverb mix to this, and I didn't want to send because I wanted it to feel extremely like by itself in a spacious environment, so I put it as not as a send but as an insert. And also if you open up the automation, you can see that this track here has a volume automation going on, and that's going from 10.1 dB to here. And then we totally cut off because that's what the song does. You don't want any reverb tail spoiling that section when the singing comes in. So let's play it and hear it sounds, and hear the auto filter at work. And it just pulls down to zero. And then here we have a reverse cymbal. I'm just going to play it. This is an audio file. Sounds like this. Now, how do you get a reverse cymbal? Very, very simple. I personally use a dry standard kit under acoustic drum kits, dry standard kit. And then I compressed it with a Type R kick drum compressor, mucked around a little bit, and basically what I got was this. which is a forward cymbal, not a reverse cymbal, right? What I did was I put this bounce in place and basically to a new track, and this is what I got, right? And this would be forward as well. And I would select that region, go to File, Function, Reverse. And when I reverse it, I would get this file, which is the reversible. And I would place that at the right place, just cut it up, such that it would hit right at the end. And that's it. That's how you get the reverse cymbal. So extremely straightforward. And there's also this synth here, right? Slowly goes up. And it's a bit like a little organy sounding synth. Same thing, cuts up right at the end. There's an auto filter as well, right? And then there's a space designer before the auto filter. And this one, I use a really big one at 4.9 seconds church tower. Right. So all of them sort of have this buildup and this volume automation. This one goes from zero. And then I have this orchestral kit, which also has automation. It's just this kit over here under orchestral, percussion, orchestral kit. And I just need the little bell trees. So just a little glitter to bring everything in. So it sounds like that. Right, so let's go on to the verse. Now we got our kicks here, and what we have here is a drum kit, which is under the channel strip here, Bluebird drum kit. Yep, and yeah, you can pick it from here as well. Just pick drum kit designer stereo, and then pick the Bluebird kit. And I added an enveloper, just to change the output time a little. Push the gain down. And I added a compressor. And I used a Type R type drum kit. So I normally start from some basic kit or compressor setting. And then I sort of tweak it to the sound that I want. And in this case, I'm just using the kicks here. So this is how it sounds. See, if I took out the everything, it's going to sound like this. So it's more ambient. You hear the sort of reverb of the space, right? And if I compress that, you hear it even more. So I use the enveloper to remove some of that reverb. Make it a bit tighter. And I paired it with another kick, which is under drums and percussion, single drums, kicks, layer kicks, and body kick C117. And here's how it sounds. It's got a bit of high end, but mostly I wanted it for the body. And when you put them together, so you get a bit of that organic kick up here and the deep dancey kick down here, right? So the next one, it's the claps. Now, I couldn't find great claps in Logic Pro, but what I found was this under drums and percussion, electronic drum kits, there's a human body rhythm kit, right? I'm gonna take everything out, and this is how it sounds. So two kinds of claps, right? And claps are nicer if you sort of like flam them a little bit, don't put them right on top of each other, sort of have a, yeah, sounds nicer that way. And I thought they were a bit too low, so I pitched them, mix 100%, I pitched them up by 10 semitones. So they sound now like this. Slightly between sort of like finger snaps and claps. And then I added a compressor to bring out the volume, and I added a VCA snare compressor. And always remember, you can muck around with the makeups a little bit, turn on the limiter, muck around with thresholds a little bit, and here's how it sounds. A bit snappier, right? I know you can hear a little bit of the sort of artifacting from pitching, but it gets lost in the mix, so it's pretty alright. Now I send it to the bus as well. Bus 3, space designer, nice haul. Under medium spaces, hauls, 1.7 seconds, nice haul. Right, and here with a reverb. That's pretty okay. So let's move on to the synths. Now, this one sounds like this. Right, it just follows the rhythm. And I use an ES2. And what I use was analog horns under synth brass. Mucked around with it a bit, but basically that's the base I use it from. Pan it to the right, send it to the same bus. And what I like to do with synths is pair it with another one, right? Another ES2 this time. Also analog horns, right? But this is the low end. So I put it separately because I can control the direction and the pan a little bit, the levels differently. So this is what you get. Right? Now, the top level synth, I added something else. And this, it's just a little, just like a high-end thing. And it's under ES2, still analog horns. Same bus 3. So if you play it together, you get this. And you can hear that this one's panned to the right, but this one's panned center. So you don't want everything sort of like going one direction, right? And I have another ES2. And in this case, it's just a basic one, right? It's a standard one, actually. A synth here. Under synthesizer strings, authentic strings. So I use a preset. And I took out the channel EQ, which is nothing anyway. And then all these were part of the original one. So here's how it sounds. And you can see that this one's panned to the left, right? And so is the bass. So when you do this pan to the left and pan to the right, you get this. And I think with synths, you always have to stack them, get different textures, you know, and then pan them left, right, or, you know, one center, one more to the right, one center more to the left. Play around with it, different levels, stacking them so that you get a richer sound. Right? And then you have your small high notes here. Now, let's have a listen to what's here. Yep, it's like this electric guitar. So under guitars, electric guitars, and 80s electric, I added an enveloper to take away the attack a little bit, because if not, it's too sharp. Let's take away everything. Sounds like this. And you can see there's some note bending going on there, right? So, yep. And I added an enveloper, take away a bit of the edge. You can hear the attack is sort of like gone away a little bit. And I added an amp. And if you look at the amp, I added a crunch amp, a brown stack crunch. And here's how it sounds. Pretty cool, nice and warm, you know. And then I took a channel EQ to take away most of the high end, added a little bump at the mid lows, low mids. Sounded pretty good. And then I sent it to bus 3 again. So nice little background to the whole music piece. Here we go. Hey, you tell your friends it was not- And there are extra hand claps here, which I got from another kit under World Asian Asian Kit. And you can see these hand claps here. Right? And I just sent it to Bass 3 as well. So everything is sent to the same reverb. And sounds like this. And together with the human effect hand clap, sounds like this. So,
friends, it was nice to meet them, but I hope I'm...
And that's it. So now, as it gets bigger and bigger, you get more electronic drums coming in. And let's explore that a little bit. Now we got an 808 drum here, which is under Drums and Percussion Electronic Drum Kits, EXS 808. So it's EXS version of the 808. And this is the MIDI here. And let's have a listen to that. So I only took this track for its hats. And you gotta mix and match when you wanna really recreate the kind of sounds that you want. You can't just rely on one kit. And this one got a nice 808 hat, so that's cool. And then this one, it's a nice, like, noisy kind of clap. And I found it under single drum snares, electronic snare D136. And I sent it to the reverb as well. And you get the little clap here. And you pair it with those claps, sounds like this. Yep. And then we have another track here, which is like a dancey kind of clap, right? And I found it under Drums and Percussion, Electronic Drum Kits, Hard Techno Remix. Send it to the same reverb. And this Hard Techno Remix has this kind of clap. And if you add it with that, so that's our big snare right there. And under the Latin kit, right, let's see what we got here. Aha, like a little kind of jingly percussion. So it's under World South American Latin kit. And with the hats and everything, it sounds like this. And with the extra hand claps and the kicks, so yeah, you gotta be combining kits to really create your drum sounds. Now we have a Liverpool bass here, which is one of my favorite deep basses to use. A very generic bass under bass, electric bass, Liverpool bass, and here's how it sounds. Simple, but very useful bass. And with the kit. Just gives that really big low end. And this is an electric piano. Slight bell kind of sounds. And what we use were the clean tines of mine. And send it to Bus 1, which is a different kind of reverb, 2.7 seconds big chamber, which is the same as the earlier piano that we used. So here's how it sounds.
I know it breaks your heart, moved to the city and I broke down barren.
So just that section. And then we move on to a bit of pad-like stuff. And this Sparkle Motion, which is under ES2, under Synth Motion Sequences, Sparkle Motion. And you can see there's some really, really low, no automation, but some really low mix here, just 21 decibels. Yep, like a pad, just to make it a bit fatter. And then there's an electric guitar here, which is under Guitars, Electric Guitars, Clean Electric Guitar 1. And if you take out the amp and the reverb, So it's playing the same track as this one. I just copied it over. And yeah, now let's turn on the amp. And we got our amp to clean. Awesome tweet. So this one's cleaner. And we send our bus to bus one, which is the 2.7 seconds big chamber. So let's have a listen. So let's listen to everything. And with just the music. You have to remember that all these are just the basics. I'm not going super detailed into the mix or the small details of it, but just to get the right vibe. So now we have the breakdown. And the breakdown is pretty straightforward. We have a piano, and the piano is under Steinway Grand Piano with lots of reverb sent through a bus to bus one. Sounds like that. It's actually the same as the intro piano bits, and it just repeats. And then we have this house organ, which is an ESM. So I just picked house organ under ESM and added a huge reverb as well, 4.9 seconds church tower, which is the same track that we used before. So sounds like that. Just follows the singing. Baby, pull me close. So, and then you have a long line Liverpool bass. And then Sparkle Motion comes back again. This is basically the same track, but I copied it over with this and I upped the volume a little bit to 15. This one is 21 and this one's 15. Let's play. Pad-like stuff. And if you play everything together without the vocals, so it repeats four times, and you have a little snare coming in right at the end, and it's under drums, single drum snares, electronic snares, 54, right? And it sounds like that. And we wanted it higher, so I played it on an A1 instead. It sounds like this. Right? And for that lead, right, the lead line, I used a retro synth. And I use a synth lead called Tempo Maker, and I sent it through a guitar amp because I needed it more distorted. This is an American stack distort. Let's listen to it without the amp. Sounds like that. Too synth-like, right? And this is the low end of it. And I span slightly to the left with the amp. Sounds more like it. So we did a tempo maker here as well for the high bits. And here's how it sounds. So there's the same notes going on, except that they're an octave from each other. It's sent through the same amp, American Stack Distort, sent to bus 3, but there's some channel EQing going on just to bring out the honk in that section for the high end. And these sections here are actually the same as this section here, right? It's just copied over. All these are copied over, this one's as well. And basically you add the lead on top. And there you have it. I hope you learned something useful today, like how you don't have to have crazy sounds. You can put fairly typical stuff and craft them really well, like the Chainsmokers did on this track. If you like this, you can download the project at the link below, and please subscribe for more. See ya.